A 17-year-old gunned down in front of his younger brother and sister. Laverne police say it centered around an ad to sell an iPhone. News Channel 5's Matthew Torres was in the courtroom with the two teen suspects as the victim's family begins to heal.
It's in this parking lot in a normally quiet community in Laverne where police say the 17-year-old was shot and killed. Neighbors say people were out and about. His own younger brother and sister were here when he was shot.
And we love him deeply, and he'd be missing.
It's the harsh reality family members of Yudjy Cherubin have to accept. The 17-year-old Laverne High Jr. is no longer coming back to a big family who remembers him as a lovable comedian.
He's a laughable boy. Doesn't matter what's going on, he always laughs and make people laugh.
His uncle says he was a godly man, respectful, and a stellar academic. Majority of the students at his school wore black to remember him.
But you never know when something's going to happen. A bullet can come through your window at any time.
Neighbors along George Buchanan Drive can't help but feel uneasy. Police say Cherubin met two teens there after responding to an ad on the app Let Go about an iPhone sale. His younger brother was in the car and said after exchanging money, one of the teens shot him in the face. Two other witnesses tried to stop him.
When everybody scattered, he hurried up and started putting the kids in the house. He said, get the kids, get the kids. I was like, what's going on?
Investigators were able to link messages on the phones to two teens and arrested them. In their court hearing, Marquez Hughes and Brian Berry kept their heads down as they faced charges of first-degree murder and conspiracy to commit first-degree murder. Their mothers were also there hoping for a chance to fight for their sons, one getting emotional and left the courtroom. As the investigation continues, Cherubin's family is deciding to take a surprising step.
But we forgive him, but we like to have justice done correctly.
Matthew Torres, News Channel 5.
A school official tells us one of the teen suspects attended the school in 2015 but was moved to an alternative school after 2 days for disruptive behavior. The other is a current student. Tonight they remain at the juvenile detention center.